Greetings from the Northwoods of Michigan's Upper Peninsula. I'm Natasha, and this is Plant Centered Living. Today I'm sitting outside in front of my woodshed. It's a beautiful summer morning here in the far north. The birds are singing, the sun is shining, and I just came off of a great weekend. I had my first art show ever with my line called Cabin Girl, and it was such a success. And one of the things that I enjoyed most about the show was all the conversations that I got to have with people as they're passing by, looking at my artwork, and just browsing. Well, one of the things that I did notice is I can't believe the number of conversations that actually came back to food and people's disordered relationship with food. It was funny how the conversation always seemed to come down to dieting and what someone had done or hadn't done. And so I wanted to make this video again this week to kind of talk about and reinforce the idea that, you know, a plant-centered lifestyle is not a diet. You know, you are going to change the way that you eat, but if you go into that with a diet mindset, you simply are not going to be successful. So one of the women I talked to this weekend at the art show, she said, you know, I've lost a lot of weight recently, and I just don't know how I did it. And I said, well, you know, did you do anything differently? She said, I just ate what I wanted, and I ate when I wanted, and the pounds just came off. And I said to her, that's great. And more people need to get into that mindset. If you're eating the right foods, you can eat as much as you want, when you want, and you are still going to feel good, you're not going to be hungry, and your body is going to self-regulate. If you are hungry, that means that your body needs more fuel. So I received several comments this past week on my video from last week, and I did want to share those because they are very pertinent. I actually printed them off and I have them here. I'd like to read them to you. This one is from a woman named Kelly. I've been thinking about your most recent video, the whole diet thing. I have had a disordered relationship with food for a very long time. I'm still struggling with plant-based eating, but it's not as bad as it was in the beginning. Sometimes I still portion my food, thinking about a serving size and what I should be eating. It's easier for me to catch myself now, though, and take a step back and eat what I need to be satisfied. And that's the key, enough to be satisfied so that you are not hungry and therefore going to continue to obsess about food. She also goes on to say, I also get hungry sometimes between meals and think to myself that I shouldn't be hungry. It's not time to eat again. Again, I have to take a step back and do some serious self-talk. If I'm hungry, I need to eat, and it's okay. And I'm really glad that you wrote, Kelly, because I think a lot of other people are struggling with this same issue, and it helps people to feel not so alone if others are out there sharing. So thank you for taking the time. I also had someone else write in with a really great question and comment about non-dairy milks. Hi, Natasha. I recently started making my own coconut milk to replace cow milk. I can live without cheese, but it's the yogurt that I'll have a hard time with. Have you tried making yogurt from it yet? Can I even make yogurt from coconut milk? Can I make kefir from it? The answer is you absolutely can. There's some great resources out there on the internet if you just Google non-dairy kefirs, non-dairy yogurts. And for those of you who are not up to making your own yet, there are many different varieties that you can buy at your local supermarket or health food store or co-op. There is almond yogurt, there's coconut yogurt, there is, gosh, I'm trying to think, soy yogurt. You name it, they're out there. You just have to find the one that you like the best. Thank you, Kelly and Vicky, for your questions. I sincerely appreciate them, and I know our other listeners appreciate them as well, because when one of us is thinking something, probably somebody else out there is thinking the same thing or is experiencing some of the same emotions or the same challenges that we are, and by sharing them, we all become stronger. So send your questions, everybody, and we will share them out each week. Additionally, if you need help, get in touch with me. Call me 906-235-5430. Visit me online at plantcenteredliving.com. And you can also follow me on Facebook at Plant Centered Living. Have a great week, everyone. Talk to you soon.